और थर्ड मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट फैक्टर विच इज़ इफेक्टिंग आवर वेदर, दैट इज़ एल्टीट्यूड. वेल गाइस, एल्टीट्यूड मीन्स हाइट फ्रॉम द सी लेवल. एज वी गो यू नो फ्रॉम द सी ऑफ सरफेस ऑफ द अर्थ टू हायर, यू विल सी द डिक्रीज इन टेम्परेचर. इन शॉर्ट, यू कैन से दैट द हायर इज़ यू नो एल्टीट्यूड, द कोल्डर इज़ टेम्परेचर. वेल गाइस, टेम्परेचर ड्रॉप्स यू नो आफ्टर एवरी 1,000 फीट. दैट मीन्स यू कैन से दैट मरी इज़ लोकेटेड अबव द सी लेवल. दैट्स वाई मरी टेम्परेचर इज़ मोर कोल्डर देन गुजरांवाला. ओके, और यू कैन से, यू कैन कंपेयर द टेम्परेचर ऑफ लाहौर विद नाथिया गली. लाहौर्स टेम्परेचर इज नाउअडेज यू नो इज बिटवीन 10 डिग्री और यू नो 7 डिग्री सेल्सियस, बट द टेम्परेचर इन नाथिया गली इज़ अराउंड -1 or -2. That's how you can understand about altitude. You have to keep one thing in your mind, that the higher is altitude, the colder is temperature. Any place which is situated at the height, you will see the temperature of that place will definitely will be less than the place which is located at plain area, such as Lahore, Gujranwala and other cities of Punjab. So altitude is affecting our weather as well. Latitude is affecting our weather as well. Latitude means distance from the equator. Altitude means the height from the sea level. And we have discussed as well about the large bodies of water. Okay, let's talk about our next mentioned factor, which is affecting our climate directly. Well, guys, that factor is air pressure. Well, air pressure is measure of the force with which air or molecule push on the surface. Well, air pressure is the greatest and at the surface of the earth, because there is more of atmosphere above you push down on you, right? So that's how you can understand that how air pressure is affecting our climate. But let's talk about our next mentioned you know factor. But before this, let me talk about the wind direction as well. When we are talking about air pressure, it is very important to talk about wind direction as well. Well guys, difference in temperature creates wind, and hot air rises, allowing the cooler air to flow underneath, and this movement of air from colder to warmer areas is called wind. Well guys, local winds are created by the normal fluctuation in temperature from day to night, but the global winds have a more direct effect on the climate of any region. Winds have a great impact on, or you can say that air has a great impact on weather changes as well. Well, when you will see the cold air is blowing, it will definitely will affect your temperature and will affect the weather of the day as well. Well guys, if the winds blow from the ocean to some other large body of water, the climate will be more moderate and the weather will heat up and cool down even slowly. But the most well-known example is about you know the southwestern monsoon winds, which brings rain in the region. Okay, so that thing is very clear, that the wind direction is also affecting, or air pressure is also affecting our climate. But let's talk about our you know second last factor, which is affecting our climate. Well, grade 5, you have to keep one thing in your mind, that there are so many factors which are affecting our climate, but we are discussing you know only the main factors. Okay, so the factor which is right now we are going to talk about, that is about the mountain barriers. Well guys, mountain affect the climate by blocking the wind and receiving more rainfall than the low-lying areas, and the reason is that when the wet air blows towards the mountains, it is forced to move upward, you know, upward by the mountains. Well guys, at higher altitude, due to the low temperature, the wet air gets cooler and you know causing the moisture and condense and falls as rain. Well, for example, the higher Himalaya mountains form a barrier which affect the climate of Pakistan as well. Well, you can say that the mountains are definitely large mass, large mass on the earth with broad base. They are blocking the winds, okay? They are blocking the winds, they are condensing the winds, and which affects our climate very directly. Because of the Himalayas mountain, Pakistan is receiving much rain, okay? Because the large barrier, because mountains are the barriers actually, or you can say that the mountains are the blockage, which are blocking the air, or which are blocking the air, and that air gives us the rain. Okay, so that's how the mountain barriers are affecting our climate. Let's talk about oceanic current. It is very important for you, all of you, to understand this this factor which is affecting our climate. Well, closer to the equator, seas are warmer. Okay, the seas which are closer to the equator, they are always warmer. And water gets cold or hot when hot or cold winds blow over them, or you can say that when they fetch the cold or hot air, it affects the water temperature as well. Well, Pakistan has a warmer water sea because the sea which is inside the Pakistan has no sea at all, but it has in near Karachi border we have an Arabian Sea. Okay, because of that sea, Pakistan water is little warmer because Pakistan is located at 23.5 degree at north latitude, right? So that's why the temperature of Pakistan is little warmer as compared to the other countries which are located inside, near the North or South Pole. Well, girls and guys, oceanic current equalized to the global temperature by moving warmer water from the equator to the polar regions and returning the cold water. Well, the majority of the sun's heat is absorbed by the ocean around the equator because the sun is vertically above the sea at the equator, and equator gets the sunlight, more sunlight as compared to the other poles of the globe. Well, if ocean currents did not distribute this heat, the summer and winter at the equator as well as at the pole would be far more extreme than what present it is presently we observe. For example, oceanic currents are distributing the heat equally to the different part of the region, okay? So if they don't do that, okay, if the if there is no if you will not feel the oceanic current, if the sorry if the ocean will not have a oceanic current, the heat will not be distributed as equally as it is distributed nowadays. You will feel the more equator will receive the more sunlight, and the equator receives the sunlight, it distributes equally, it dist the heat equator distributes the heat equally to the other part of the region as well. So you can say that oceanic current is helping equator to divide its heat in winters and in summers equally to the other regions as well. So guys, if ocean currents did not distribute this heat, the summer and winter at the equator as well as at the pole would be far more extreme than what presently we observe. This is what which you have to understand, that oceanic current is one of the most important factor which is affecting our climate. Okay, so this is all about the factors which are affecting our climate, and I'm just the thing which comes in my mind that let me divide this lecture in two parts. That's how you guys will understand this lecture in a more convenient way. Okay, so read all the factors which are mentioned on page number 30, 30, 31, and 32, so you guys will understand in a more better way what are these factors and how they are affecting our climate. Well, girls and guys, this is the right time to talk about your assignment. Okay. Your assignment is that you have to note down the temperature of three or two more big cities, two big cities such as Lahore. I gave the name of Lahore, Murray, and Quetta. You can take the name of any other, cities as well. So what you have to do, you have to, you observe their, weather reports on daily basis. Then you have to make a, chart or table, or you have to draw the bar graph. Okay, then you will see the difference between the weather of three different cities which are locating on the same, inside the same country. Okay, so girls and guys, off from here. I will see you in your lecture number 7. Till then, take care of yourself. Do whatever you want to do, but make sure you are not, creating any trouble for your parents. So, Allah Hafiz. Bye bye.